Blackstone Audio presents Mr. Playboy, Hugh Hefner and the American Dream by Stephen Watts. For Olivia Claire Watts. The American citizen lives in a world where fantasy is more real than reality. We risk being the first people in history to have been able to make their illusions so vivid, so persuasive, so realistic, that they can live in them. Daniel Boorstin, The Image. Humankind cannot bear very much reality. T.S. Eliot, Four Quartets. Men look at women. Women watch themselves being looked at. John Berger, Ways of Seeing. The truth was that Jay Gatsby of West Egg, Long Island, sprang from his platonic conception of himself. So he invented just the sort of Jay Gatsby that a 17-year-old boy would be likely to invent. And to this conception, he was faithful to the end. F. Scott Fitzgerald, The Great Gatsby. When an interviewer asked my mother whether she was proud of me, she answered, "Oh, yes, but I would have been just as happy if he'd been a missionary." Later I told her, "But, Mom, I was." Hugh Hefner, Interview with the Author. Introduction. The Boy Next Door. Mention of Hugh Hefner instantly evokes a host of images that dance through the imagination. Visions of voluptuous women and uninhibited sex, mansion parties and celebrity entertainers, grotto hot tubs and round beds, smoking jackets and sleek sports cars. Such mental pictures, of course, stem from Hefner's role as founder and publisher of Playboy magazine. Over the last 50 years, Playboy's monthly array of hedonistic messages, which Hefner has supported with a publicity-drenched lifestyle, has made him an impresario of sex and leisure in the United States, and has brought him dazzling fame. Like Walt Disney in the movies, Muhammad Ali in sports, or Elvis Presley in popular music, Hefner has come to signify a personal style, a fantasy. Like these other larger-than-life figures, he has become an icon of modern American life who has made a significant impact on our culture. But the climb to the pinnacle of acclaim and influence proved to be a long one. In late December 1952, a forlorn 26-year-old Hefner stood on a bridge at Michigan Avenue in downtown Chicago. Bundled up against the frigid winter weather, he grimly stared out over the Chicago River. His life seemed at low ebb as he strained against the bonds of an unsatisfying marriage, flinched at the unsettling prospect of parenthood, and balked at the thought of returning to an unfulfilling job with few career prospects. This unhappiness had been driven home by an event a few days earlier. He had co-hosted an alumni show at his old high school where, along with his best friend, he had told jokes, performed skits, and sang a few numbers while emceeing the festivities. An enthusiastic audience had responded with laughter and applause. That magical evening left Hefner yearning to recapture the enthusiasm, optimism, and sense of achievement of his high school years when he had been a popular and creative leader among students. But now those youthful hopes seemed far away. Standing on the bridge, he muttered, "Is this all there is? Where is my life going?" He silently vowed to do something to escape the ennui that threatened to suffocate him. While not quite on par with Edward Gibbon's famous reverie amid the ruins of Rome that prompted him to write the history of the decline and fall of the Roman Empire, even though critics would later accuse Hefner of starting just such a process of degeneration in the United States, this episode marked a turning point in the young man's life. A few weeks later, he started his own magazine. The results would be stunning. Within 15 years, Hefner and Playboy had taken the country by storm. From its modest beginnings in Chicago, the magazine grew.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.